Good morning, children. Today we'll be discussing the statistic questions 14 to 16. So the 14th question is, find the significance of difference in the mean index of brightness of 50 boys and 50 girls with the following values. So there you have four columns: sex, mean, standard deviation, standard error. Boys 91.2, girls 90.1, SD is 37 and 31.2, SE is 5.23 and 4.41. So now the solution for this question: the means of boys X1 and girls X2 are 91.2 and 90.1 respectively. There is a difference of 1.1 between these two groups. Is the difference real or occurred by chance? That is what we are going to know. If the difference is by chance, the difference is not statistically significant. If the difference is not by chance, the difference is statistically significant. So, to understand it, Z value or standard error of mean difference is needed. So, standard error of mean difference is equal to square root of SD1 square by N1 plus SD2 square by N2 is equal to square root of 1369 by 50 plus 973.44 by 50. So, standard error is coming to 6.8. The second step is calculate Z value. Z value is equal to X1 minus X2 by SE is equal to 91.1 minus 90.1 by 6.8, that is equal to 0.16. So in conclusion, Z value 0.16 is less than 1.96 SE. The difference has occurred by chance. Hence, the difference is not significant. So this is the solution to the 14th question. 15th question is, a group of 15 normal children had a mean bilirubin level of 1.05 mg/cent and SD of 0.34. Another group of 15 children with infantile cirrhosis of liver had mean bilirubin level of 4.99 mg/cent and SD of 2.52. Is the difference between the two means statistically significant? So groups are normal and infantile cirrhosis. Numbers are 15, 15. Mean is 1.05 and 4.99. SD is 0.34 and 2.52. So now we will see whether there is statistical significance. Solution: the mean bilirubin level of normal and infantile cirrhosis children are 1.05 and 4.99 mg respectively. There is a difference of mean of 3.94 mg/cent between these two groups. Is the difference occurred by chance or not? If the difference is by chance, the difference is not statistically significant. If the difference is not by chance, the difference is statistically significant. To understand it, again the Z or standard error of mean difference is needed. There is a difference of mean of 3.94 mg between the two groups. So using the same formula, square root of SD1 to the power of 2 by N1 plus SD2 square root of SD2 by N2. So it is coming to 0.657. Standard error is 0.657. Z value is equal to minus 5.996. So in conclusion, Z value minus 5.996 is more than 1.96. So the difference has not occurred by chance, hence the difference is significant. The third question is, attack rates among the vaccinated and unvaccinated against measles are given below. Prove the protective value of vaccine by two tests. Table value of x to the x square is equal to 6.66. corresponding to P is equal to 0.01 at degrees of freedom is equal to 1. So vaccinated, unvaccinated, total. Attacked 10 unvaccinated it is 26, total is 36, not attacked 90, unvaccinated 74, total is 164, total when you combine attacked and non-attacked 100 and the total is 200. Attack rate is 10%, in unvaccinated it is 26% and total is coming to 18%. Now the solution, from the given data it can be observed that attack rate is lower in vaccinated group at 10% when compared to that in unvaccinated group at 18%. Can this difference be attributed to chance, or does it indicate a real association of attack rate with the vaccination status? That's the question. We start with the null hypothesis that there is no association and whatever the difference seen is only by chance, and test it by chi-square test. Calculating expected values from observed values. Expected values are the numbers in the four cells if the null hypothesis is true. These are calculated for each cell by multiplying the column and row totals and dividing by grand total. Expected value, column total into row total divided by grand total. Expected value 100 into 36 by 200 minus 18. Similarly, expected values are calculated for each cell and summarized in the following table. Vaccinated, values observed, expected E. Observed is O. Unvaccinated, observed is O, expected is E. So attacked it is 10, non-attacked it is 90, total is 100 again. Expected 18, not attacked low 82, unvaccinated observed is 26, not attacked low 74, total 100. Expected is 18 and 82. So on the whole, attacked it is total is 36, non-attacked 164, on the whole total is coming to 200. Differences of observed values to expected values. Observation to E. This is attacked is minus 8, not attacked is 8. Unvaccinated 8 and minus 8. So calculating square values of observed and expected. Vaccinated, observed minus E, expected square 64. Attacked, not attacked 64. Unvaccinated also 64. Calculating attacked minus expected square by E. Vaccinated it is 3.6, not attacked 0.8. Unvaccinated 3.6, not attacked is 0.8. Calculating square value is equal to sum of all four values of observed minus attacked square by E. Vaccinated, attacked is 3.6, not attacked is 0.8, total is 4.4. Unvaccinated, again it is coming to 3.6, non-attacked 0.8, 4.4. So grand total is coming to 8.8. So value is 8.8. degree of freedom is equal to R minus 1 into C minus 1 is equal to 2 minus 1 into 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, where R is equal to number of rows and C is equal to number of columns in the given table. Table value of chi-square is equal to 6.64, corresponding to P is equal to 0.01, at degree of freedom is 1. The calculated chi-square value of 8.8 is greater than the given chi-square value at P is equal to 0.01 at freedom value of 1, degree of freedom 1. So in the conclusion, difference of attack rates of measles between the two groups, vaccinated and unvaccinated, is highly significant. Thank you.